Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me. Today we're talking about red and the color red, particularly on the lips. There was a clinical study done about women getting picked up in a bar and what color lipstick worked the best. And at the end of the video, of course, as always, you'll get Raj's recommendations. Do you want to get picked up? So remember, if you like the video, click like below and don't forget to click the bell so they notify you when the new videos come up for your viewing pleasure. So today we're talking lips, and we often talk about lip filler, lip size. It's a main driver to aesthetic practices, as we know. Some people feel the lips have gotten too big. Across cultural norms, they're very different. Ratios of upper to lower, 50-50 lips, all kinds of things regarding lips and facial balance and beauty. And that's the key, beauty and angles. Angles are all important, but today we're talking color. There was a study done, I kid you not, of course it was in France. The French love this stuff. And what they did, they had four different locations of bars, and they had women in the bar and then observers. And they put different color lipstick on the women. The women were picked, rated from a scale of 1 to 9 out of a group. They picked the ones in the 4 to 5 range. So one would say average. And of course, there's no average person. But on the scale of beauty, they were around 4 or 5. So that controlled for overall beauty. And when they picked them, they put them in the bar on these four different nights, and they put different color lipstick on them. The colors they used were red, pink, brown, and then no color. These women had no other makeup on and no foundation, so it was just the lipstick that was showing color. What they measured was the number of encounters and the time from the women entered the bar to the time they were approached by a male. In the order of the color I gave you, they were approached quickest and the most often by red, followed by pink, followed by brown, followed by no lipstick. What do we learn from that? Wear red lipstick and you'll get picked up. Well, that might be one takeaway, but more importantly for beauty, what we often look at, certainly the colors and the reflections on the face, if you think about it, often the cheek is highlighted in red. The lips, red as we know, is the most common color for attractiveness, and this is backed up by this study as well, but other studies also. But it's not just red, because studies have looked at the nose, and if the nose is red, it's associated with negativity. And we know that people look at our face and decide, are we rested, awake, have energy, or no energy, and most importantly, are we healthy or not? So why the color red on the lips? Well, red is associated with a few things. Number one, healthiness. And this is studied and proven. It's also associated with fertility. So hormones and estrogen, and during a cycle where estrogen's higher in the female, the lips become a little more red, thus a little more attractive, and thus it's thought fertility then ensues. Red is also the color of arousal. So it's thought to be increased blood flow to an area, of course, is arousal, and the lip, a mucous membrane, when it's red, is associated with arousal. So there you go, red is the color. So Raj's recommendation on this, how do you get naturally red lips so you have them all the time and makeup can be a choice? Well, one method is Plasmasculpt. That's taking PRF, platelet-rich fibrin, which is your blood product, injecting it into the lip. They're larger than you want. When we put the product in, gives you a window into what the size would look like. But as that clot releases growth factors, as it rejuvenates the lip, what do we see? We see decreased lines, increased redness, and a little bit of volume. And you can use this if you've had lip filler prior. As far as topical goes, lip plumpers can be amazing. They have immediate effect, and ours has a peptide. You get longer effects from that one and others like it. So you can get an immediate plumping, redness, and a longer term plumping. Again, you can use this even if you've had Plasmasculpt or fillers, and it can be a way to help those results last longer. Another slightly more invasive option, of course, is fillers. And we all know about the fillers that create structure and folds, lift the edge of the mouth. But what about for fillers that create just a bit of redness and get rid of the fine lines and give a little more projection? You can use lightweight or smaller fillers, small molecule size like Restylane Silk, for example, which is a 50 micron size. You can put it very superficially in the lip and it will smooth out nicely with a bit of massage. It hydrates, makes the lip a little more pink, draws a little water in, makes it a little more sexy. So it's not just all about getting projection and a structural, big, unnatural lip. We have fillers that can create that redness that was shown to be in that study very important for attractiveness. So there's a few recommendations if you want to have a slightly more red lip, if you want to obtain that color so that you don't have to wear makeup. And we know red lips, red cheeks associated with beauty and attractiveness, red nose, not so much. What do you do to get red lips? Join me on this YouTube channel, stay posted, stay tuned, subscribe, join us over on Instagram where we will continue this conversation to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.